Since the release of Photoshop Beta, I've been seeing some crazy results with the way people use the new Generative Fill feature. But in this video, I'll be showing you a new way I've been using it to create these results that I haven't seen used that often. Now, just a quick message, if you do find this tutorial helpful, it would really help out if you can subscribe, like, or just comment down below if you have any questions. So, I'm not an expert in Photoshop. I'm sure we've all tried using the Generative Fill feature to change the image style or look by selecting the whole image and using prompts like painting or sketch. And I've even tried using like film look, but usually the results look like these, so yeah. Now the method I learned uses the quick mask tool. And you simply do this by pressing Q. And when you're in this mode, this quick mask mode, you should see your layer is highlighted in red. Now the way I've been doing this might not be the right way, but it's gotten me the result so far. First, I adjust the brightness of the black based on how much of the paint look I want. You can think of this like the higher the percentage, the larger the brush strokes, and the more the original image is replaced. We are essentially adjusting the transparency of your selection, so you can think of it like that as well. I just pretty much paint over or color in the areas I want my selection. And then if I'm selecting the whole image, I would just use the shape tool and just select the whole image. Once you're done selecting, just press Q again and you should see the red highlight is gone. Enter your prompt, just to list the prompts that I've used to get these results. It would be like oil painting, painting, watercolor. Yeah, those were pretty much the only prompts that I've used. And you're pretty much done. I do have another Photoshop beta tutorial on my channel, so check that out if you're interested. But yeah, see you in the next video.